Halfwit and Marcus are in the kitchen.
I feel a bit sick after that, actually.
Bloody hell.
Undercooked potato. I could have made so many lentils with that garlic. Like, three lunches. Oh, well. And, like, you know what? It annoys me when people cook and then complain about it. Like, oh, it's so hard, blah, blah, blah. Like, there's more people who want to cook than are required to cook any particular meal.
Well, I think you know why he cooks, don't you?
Yep.
Captain Game Plan.
Indeed.
So whenever he talks to me now, I'll just...
Pardon?
I think I like where I'm at now with him because I don't really give a fuck what I say to him. I'm just like, yeah, whatever, mate.
I'm fucking insulted that I've been up for eviction and he hasn't.
Mm. Goes to show the power of the game plan, though.
Yep.
But I think this week, more than last week, people are properly aware of it now and can see the effects of it, so I don't think you'll go this week. It'll be interesting to see what's happening next week.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I think it would be in your best interest to actually go around and talk to people who you don't nearly talk about and just be friendly and carry on like that.
Hmm. Well, I kind of have been doing
yeah.
that.
Oh, no, definitely, but, you know, so I'm sure that there's still some areas of the community where periods of your time might be better employed.
OK. Who are you thinking in particular?
Not in bad ways, but... I think, like, intermediate people, like Carly and stuff, people like that, whereas they certainly haven't got bad things to say about you, I still think... I mean, I don't... Obviously, nobody knows who's voting for who or whatever, but there's certain people who you won't get on with and you know them, but then it's how far their influence goes to the other people.
Mm.
And, you know, I don't think it'll be a game plan of you to be friendly with people who, because I think you're the type of person who would just be friends with people anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I have already been doing that a bit. And it's, I think I can take that further, yeah. I'm gonna just emphasise that even more. I think, like, just as a simple numbers game, where it's at right now, the kind of people that have been going, like, as a simple numbers game, it's going to have to require probably a few of the people who have been voting for me to go. Like, so... We'll see.
PM. Lisa and Chris are in the kitchen.
I see.
Most of the housemates are in the garden.
So you look at the first lady now.
I do.
So you need the president.
I know.
Where are you going to find the president?
Not in this house.
He looks cool.
President.
Oh, coincidence.
Ooh, God, speak the devil in
yeah.
What is it? What coincidence?
We're seeing that she looks like a first lady right now.
She wishes. I'm joking.
I'm going to bet you're not allowed to say I'm joking ever again in my presence.
You don't say it. No, not again. I'm only messing.
Yeah.
If you say one more time messing, I will be a millionaire.
What?
Because you said million times.
Yeah, because you always say, I'm only joking, I'm only joking, I'm only joking, I'm only joking.
Okay, I'm serious. You look too tough,
hey,
good looking. Very, very bright.
So solving that.
Yeah?
Thank you.
No, seriously, you are.
Don't mess my hair.
Sometimes I want to be hard with you, but I can't. I don't know why.
Do you even guys do that? Or they go, hi, and you're like,
oh, you give me your head. I'll get your head luckily pretty hook, yeah.
Yes. Leave the hair alone. He comments at my toes, my scar, and my arm every single day.
He comments on them?
Yeah.
Who?
You, my toes and my scar and my arm.
You know what?
Every day. It's like, it's a way of making him feel better.
By putting other people down?
Yeah.
You're one of them people, she. Put others down so
you know what?
Every day.
I love
you. No, not with the hair, Jesus!
Sorry.
Hug Sophie. Go hug Sophie.
Oh, my hair's a mess today.
No, no, I'm fine, thank you. She don't want her hair being messed. I'm not rude. I just don't like my hair being messed or being hugged.
You want a present?
I'm not a hug person.
So fucking rude. No, seriously.
11:57 p.m. It's been 1 hour and 38 minutes since Angel became the fourth person to be evicted from the Big Brother house. 41 minutes ago, Big Brother exchanged a token for alcohol. Shri and Lisa are at the bus stop talking about Nareen.
I don't care, to be honest with you. Nah. I'm not worrying about her to be in my life, to be honest with you.
Oh, well, no, you're not. You've got past that now. I think you've,
that stage
you,
gone.
You got hurt a little bit and you dealt with it and you thought, nah, you know, you protected yourself and you thought, I ain't going there. So I think you've handled it really well. I think you've handled it really well. And whatever her and Marcus do and however close they get, I wouldn't really worry about it.
Marcus and Nareen are at the dining table talking about Lisa and Shri.
But she's coming here with a game plan, like a mission. The whole thing's a mission to her. And I do, you know, I'm getting to like her. And I've been telling everyone, saying in the diary room earlier on, I think I've made so much progress with her that she actually talks to me all the time and says, how you doing, blah, 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 blah. But still, when anything happens, she will always go back to, like, the game plan. And then that's when you always realise that no matter how friendly you are to her, she's ready to drop you at any minute for the game plan. You know, he's obviously got a game plan as well, but she's her one's better than his. Because, you know, he's sort of looking to her for advice or whatever, and like these little talks now, and also like how she took him under her wing when she realised that she could use him, because she didn't want to know him before. And then as soon as everyone else sort of got browned off of him, she's like, oh, well, I'll have you then. Two extra votes.
Fine. It's weird now, though, because I'm only starting to open my eyes to these things. Before, I was like, la, 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 la. And then I was the one that getting in trouble because I was the one just being like,
la, la. Yeah, but then that's like a tool thing as well, because she'll be saying to you, oh, they're doing this, oh, they're doing that. And then, you know, it's like you opened your eyes to what she's been saying, but then because you're the type of person who you are, you'll say something rather than, you know, and it's like you'll say stuff on behalf of somebody else, like stuff that's been planted in your mind and just left a fester. Oh, do you want your present now?
What's my present?
Surprise.
Oh, my present. Oh, yeah. Got an eyelash there or something. Yeah. What's my present?
I don't know if you want it or not.
What is it?
I don't know if it's appropriate.
Is it one of them?
No.
What is it?
It's better than that.
What? A hug?
No, it's better than that.
What?
Surprise.
What's a surprise?
Do you want it or not?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right, close your eyes then. Come here.
Okay.
No, I'll say it. Turn your head. Come here. There. There.
Oh, thank you.
Well, that's the best place. That's better than that. That's more sensual.
Oh, thank you.